Welcome back to Bloom. We are continuing countdown to the Heart Walk on November 9th, and we are excited to join with the American Heart Association to highlight some unique individuals who are making a difference. Our next guest is Holly Vega, who has been named the 2019 Armed Forces Insurance Marine Corps Spouse of the Year. What a big honor. And she's also a heart healthy advocate and co-leader with Military Hearts Matter in partnership with the Tampa chapter of the American Heart Association. Welcome, Holly.
Thank you very much.
That is a big title. The 2019 yes. Armed Forces Insurance Military Spouse of the Year. What does that mean?
Well, actually, I hold two titles.
You do?
Yes. So I was recognized for the Marine Corps Spouse of the Year, but I'm also the Armed Forces Insurance Military Spouse of the Year. So I get to I get to stand beside some beautiful, powerful women who are all advocating for something. And my advocation this year is, and has been for 7 years, is being with the American Heart Association. I have a program called Military Heart Matters, because our military hearts all matter.
Yeah, they matter, some, their heart that matters,
everything,
but also
everything
health
we're going. We have one, right?
Yeah.
We have one heart. You've got to keep it healthy and happy.
What drew you to be so passionate about heart health?
7 years ago, my brother actually had a heart attack, and we just talked about his running marathons. He was very active. Should not have had a heart attack, you would presume, at 40 years old. Mm-hmm. The stigma is that you have to be unhealthy, and that's not the case. Know your family history. Yes, what you do eat matters, and know exactly what everything means within your health.
Knowing your numbers, things like that,
it's so important. When my brother had a heart attack, I was in 29 Palms. I don't know if you've ever been there, but it's not beautiful Tampa.
Okay,
it's not tropical.
Where is that?
That is out in California.
Okay.
It is in the desert. So you do have some beautiful sunsets, but it's not Tampa beautiful with the water. And I was alone. My husband was gone. Aww. And it was a very sad time. Yeah. I had three young babies, and my mother, of course, is dealing with everything with my brother.
And we're seeing your beautiful family.
Thank you.
So did Military Hearts Matter sort of come out of that experience?
That experience, it did. My son's audiologist, Dr. Vivian Wurzel's husband, actually died from a heart attack. He had just came back from two tours in Iraq, and was running on the treadmill at Camp Lejeune, came off the treadmill, and went into cardiac arrest.
So again, and somebody that you would think, checking the boxes of healthy.
He's married to a doctor. He's, a lieutenant colonel, very active, just came back from a tour. But again, knowing how to deal with stress, how to deal with other things is a big factor of really understanding, and those numbers. And unfortunately, he did not make it. And her story spiraled into something that very touching, and I will be able to share her story forever and know that she's been my mentor through all of this.
Yeah.
And this year we'll be walking for baby Oliver, who had open heart surgery on February 14th last year, Valentine's Day. He is a Coast Guard baby.
Okay.
And there's about 14 families that are going to actually walk on November 9th. So come out and join us.
How is baby Oliver doing?
He is doing fantastic.
Good,
he just had a birthday party.
Yay!
And is, a rambunctious. Mm-hmm. You said you had a young one?
I have a four-year-old.
Yep.
But
he's rambunctious and he's everywhere. But he is our little heart warrior, and we are excited to walk along with him and share his story throughout the next month of promoting for the November 9th Heart Walk.
Yeah, this is such a personal story, too. And I also, when we say heart, we're talking about the health, but we're also talking about, like, our love, our heart. And when you're in the military and you have a spouse that's deployed, that's challenging on the hearts of the whole family. How many times have you moved?
We've moved 10 times.
Okay, how do you keep going and keep strong for your family through that?
Well, as a, as a spouse and a female, leading disease is heart disease. It touches 1 in 3 women. As a spouse, though, we have to, usually be strong for our families. And I always say, that's great. Be strong.
Yeah.
However, do not put finding your doctor on the last.
You take care of your heart, too,
first,
right?
You take care.
Yes.
Find that your specialist. Find your doctor. And that is a very hard thing to do, because you got to think, a good question always someone asks is like, how do you do with all this moving? And I say, well, have you ever moved? Think about doing that every 2 to 3 years.
It's hard, But it is a good point to make sure when you move, you're keeping up with those doctors. Mm-hmm. And you've had some fun points. You met the second lady.
I did.
Tell me about that.
Did. Back in May, we were... bunch of us, our base winners, and my five other, because I'm the sixth, but five other of our beautiful branch winners from the Army, Navy, Coast Guard, National Guard, and then, of course, Marine Corps. We were able to meet the First Lady. She came and she gave us all pretty bracelets.
Yep.
And it was a very wonderful experience.
Well, you are doing great work, and it's so personal too, and I know you're going to keep doing this, and we're going to be out there with you at the Heart Walk, and we would love for you guys to join us because WFLA News Channel 8 is excited to be a part of the Heart Walk 2019. You can join Holly as well as News Channel 8's anchor Stacey Scheibel and the WFLA News Channel 8 team in the fight against heart disease and stroke at the 2019 Tampa Heart Walk. The Tampa Heart Walk will be held on Saturday, November 9th at Raymond James Stadium. The festivities begin at 8 a.m. and Holly told me that they have goat yoga there.
Goat yoga.
So, I mean, if walking's not your thing, goat yoga could be your thing. So thank you so much, Holly. She'll be there, I'll be there, and we'll be back with more Bloom right after this.